So, how's it going, everybody? Trey Nation over here. It's Thursday. Supposed to be getting up Miami this weekend, so if you're going to be in the area, make sure you hit me up and be like, hey, I'm here in Miami. What's up? You know, and shit. Meet up, do whatever, link up, connect, network, all that good stuff. Today I'm actually going to talk to you guys about, kind of related to a past experience I just had. This one is going to be about never getting comfortable, you know, and always to make sure you keep learning. I had to do that yesterday, you know, went through a little thing yesterday, and I didn't take it like I was supposed to, or react to it like I was supposed to, so I had to relearn how to react to certain situations, no matter what's going on, no matter how I feel about it. So that brought me trying to come back to reality with that as well, and remembering what I need to do, you know, for myself as far as self-improvement goes, because at the end of the day, that's what you have to work on is yourself, and in turn, everybody else will be able to work on themselves as well, and the world will be a better place, you know. I actually just finished this morning, I finished the last few pages of Rise and Grind. This is a great book. If you have not received it or purchased your own copy, make sure that you get one. You might be able to also download an ebook. I'm not sure exactly for sure, but you can definitely check it out to see. I actually have read this other book prior to that, The Power of Broke, which is also another great book. Now I'm actually going to continue reading Think and Grow Rich. As you guys know, this is a 1938 book, but this is still relevant to today, and people today, including Dame and John, still make money off of it because they use the fundamentals to it to their benefit for their business. Okay, so as you guys know, I'm always reading, so I'm always trying to find out new information as far as what to do for myself, for my business, and to grow. Because at the end of the day, that's what you want to do is continue to grow. So when I say never get comfortable, that means literally don't get used to what you're doing right now. Don't think that what you're doing right now is okay. And all you have to do is stay where you are, because then you become stagnant. And you don't want to be stagnant because, of course, you're not progressing, you're not growing. And a lot of us, we get used to the norm. You know, we get used to what is already happening around us. And it's the same thing. We have a routine. It can get a little mundane. So with that, we forget that we have to throw in something in there to make it spontaneous. Throw in a wrench in there so that way it can be changed up. So that way we can have our brains start working again to be more creative. So that way we can adjust to whatever is going on. And that's not only, of course, with the bad things, but of course with the good things. Because if you, of course, are used to seeing something happen at all times, you're going to get used to it and you're not going to want to make any changes to it. Then it's going to be basically like a regular old day. Okay, but if there is something that you're doing every day, and the next day is you change it up, then your mind starts working, and you start actually thinking creatively as far as how you can adjust to the differences that's going on in your day. And like I said, a lot of us, we forget about that type of stuff because we get so used to where we are that we don't even want to make that step forward because we're like, well, I already know where I'm at, so I'm good to go, and I'm just going to keep it there. But at the end of the day, in actuality, it's not good for you to stay where you're at, okay? Now, of course, you can stay where you're at to perfect the way you are, but then you also want to keep moving forward by adding something else to it to perfect the next step and the next step and the next step because we don't want to stay stagnant. Okay, something, of course, a lot of the people that I study and read and talk about a lot, Dame and John is one of them. Napoleon Hill, of course, is a great example of that. And Tony Robbins and a bunch of other people that I actually follow and respect as far as when it comes to business and law of attraction. Of course, how law of attraction ties into this is the same method, same thing. It's basically just not being able to stay in one place. That you want to always keep moving forward. You always want to keep learning something new. Now, if there's something that you already know, learn something else. Learn something else. And as I tell people every day, YouTube is a new college. Okay? Because a lot of things you want to learn, you can learn on YouTube. Of course, you're not going to learn how to do open heart surgery on YouTube, which I'm pretty sure you might be able to find a video on that. But I wouldn't go off that. But as far as like anything else that you want to learn in your life, YouTube it, you know? I have a lot of things that I've learned through online that I didn't go to school for. And the crazy thing about it is I went to two different colleges, okay? So even with that, I learned, but it wasn't enough to where I learned as much as I know now. From the last 10 years that I've been learning stuff online, I know a lot more now than I had when I went to two different colleges. And again, not to knock colleges or anything like that, but But just for me, that was the best route for me as far as like expanding my thought process and expanding my mind and gaining more knowledge. So what is it that you guys are doing today to gain more knowledge, to be more self-aware, to have yourself be more improved, to be better in today so that way you can be better for your loved ones and the ones around you? What is it that you're doing? Are you reading books? Are you listening to audios? Are you connecting with other people that's like you? Are you connecting with other people who think are more above you, who are more spiritually awake than you are? Are you connecting with others who can show you how to make that next step? Do you have any mentors? Do you have any coaches you're working with? All these types of things actually will tie into it and be able to help you to understand the next thing that you need to do. So that's where you can evolve in this world today. Like I said, I took a step back yesterday by vibrating low. I never wanted to do that, and it took me like that. It actually happened so quick that I didn't even realize it until it was too late. So now I know that I have to be next time self-aware, and that everything like I was doing in the past before I make any kind of steps, before I take any type of action, that I need to think first, and before I do that, so that way I can know exactly where I need to be mentally. And it's easy to get drawn into your old habits if you have changed them from your old habits and you are actually working on good habits and replacing those bad habits. So if somebody knows how to push those buttons, they can get you like that. So instead, what I say is take that time to pause, to reflect, and then decide if it's even worth putting that effort into it. Okay? And what I should have did, if I did that yesterday, I would have saved me a lot of headache last night. But everything happens for a reason, so I don't knock myself and I don't judge myself for it, because I feel like at the end of the day, it was what was supposed to happen, so that way I can know what I needed to work on to be better, so that way this can never happen again, and nothing like it, okay? So that's what life experience is all about. You know, you can't take yourself, you can't be hard on yourself, you can, of course, we already do it already as it is, but you can't continue to be hard on yourself, because we have to use them as lessons in life and make sure that we can use them for the better, to do better in the future, okay? Hopefully this made a lot of sense to you guys. Hopefully you guys can relate to what I'm talking about as well. And if you have any questions or any comments about the video, make sure that you go, of course, leave some comments at the bottom. And I will upload this on my social networks as well, so you guys can definitely check that out. And I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. I will actually won't be at work tomorrow because I will be on my trip. So I will see you guys while I'm on my way to Miami, alright? So y'all have a great day, and I hope you guys enjoy your beautiful weekend, alright?